Welcome to Seattle. Hi guys, welcome to Seattle, or I don't know why I'm welcoming you because we're here together, but yeah, we in Seattle, baby. A little solo trip. This is my first ever solo trip. Crazy. Bro, we need to get into what happened at the airport today because this could be a very different story right now, but I just need to get acquainted and get settled and we can chat. Oh my God, look at this mirror. Like, it's so big. The lighting is so, it's huge. I don't know how I missed it. Oh my God, I love this mirror so much. It's so cute. It's just so nice. Why did I pick Seattle? So I was like, okay, I want to change the scenery. I like a city vibe. I want like a walkable city. Like I want to be able to just like leave the hotel and just like walk around and not have to rely on Ubers or cabs or anything. And somewhere that I could just like do what I would regularly do in a day. Do you know what I mean? Like I'm not trying to go anywhere tropical. I'm not trying to do up like holiday like that, if that makes sense. Like I just wanted a change of scenery and I wanted to be alone. Like I love being alone so much. Like I can't actually really explain that, but I love being around, like I love being around my people, but I also love being alone and just like chilling. I don't even know how I came to Seattle, but how I came to the conclusion of Seattle, but I did a quick TikTok search of like things you can do. I was like, yeah, looks good enough. And here I am. I did pre-book a couple things, literally just a couple, and then everything else we'll figure out. But tonight, so I wanted to go to a comedy show. Over the past couple years, I've been to a couple comedy shows. Like I went to Trevor Noah, I went to Kevin Hart, and then I've been to like some like amateur ones, like just like locals. And it's actually really fun. I would have never thought that I would like it. I would have thought that maybe I'd find them cringy. But every time I've gone, I've thoroughly, like, quite enjoyed them. Anyway, so I was like, oh, I want to go to, like, a comedy show. So I found this, like, improv comedy thing. And, like, they include the audience in making the decisions, which is why it's improv, as to, like, what happens next in the story. So I'm going to that tonight. So I'm gonna start getting ready now because it's like a 20-minute walk and I need to stop and get something to eat because I'm hungry. Like I'm actually so hungry. My plan was to stop at a grocery store, but I think I'll just go tomorrow morning and get like some fruit and stuff and snacks. But yeah, the plan for tonight is get ready and go to this comedy show. Yeah. Bag is like popping out the seams with jackets. I might have gone a bit overboard, but I don't regret it right now.
Anyway, I'm starving, so I left like almost an hour before the show actually starts. I don't think I have enough time to like go somewhere, it's like a restaurant, and like sit down and like order something to eat. So I'm just gonna, there was a couple like fast foodie places close by the venue, so I'm just gonna do that. I'm definitely a little flustered right now. I have been flustered since I arrived, and I think I just need to have like a quiet time. So like when I get back, I'll do like the whole like chill night thing. Yeah, I keep forgetting that I'm in the States. It's giving very much Vancouver, but not. Like, it's very evident that this is not Canada. One thing I've noticed so far in the like 3 hours that I've been here is that people are a lot more like vocal. Like, I've walked past people and they're like, oh, I like your jacket. Oh, I like your pants. Oh, I like your trousers. Or I like your shoes or whatever. Like, in Canada, like, nobody's doing that to you. Like, even if they love what you're, like, what you have going on, like, they're not going to... I don't know, like, because they like yelled across the street to me, which normally doesn't happen in Calgary. And if it does, like, that person is an outgoing person, and I can tell you that for free. My goal is to walk everywhere. The only place I'm not walking to is the airport, because that place was a bit far. It was a 20-minute drive. But everywhere that I kind of want to go to, I think is like a 10-minute walk. So that's like a 30-minute... Sorry, a 10-minute drive. So that's like a 30-minute walk max. Oh, Cheesecake Factory. I'm also trying to find a place. I want to go to dinner tomorrow, like a sit-down restaurant dinner. And I thought it would be hard. Like, I don't know. Not that I thought it'd be hard. Oh, this place is nice. This is Cheesecake Factory. Yep. I've never been to Cheesecake Factory. Maybe I'll go to Cheesecake Factory tomorrow. There's a cinema. So maybe I'll watch a movie. I don't know, on like Sunday, Monday night, like, I don't know. And there was like this game spot. So cool, like, I'm loving this so far. I also need to cross to the other side of the street, so let me do that right now. Oh, look at the lights. Just finished at the improv comedy show. It was so like, that is so impressive. So it was a musical, like it was musically based, but they asked the audience like, where do you want, like, what's the location? What are we doing? You know, what are the names of the people? Like, they come in knowing nothing, nothing. And their ability to keep up the storyline and like, just like feed off of each other was absolutely insane. It's one thing to do improv, but I think to do musical improv, that's another like type of creativity. Cause like they were making song, like I have like three of the songs stuck in my head. Like they made good songs based off of the storyline and taking into account all the context that other characters had already said. Like, I think that's insane. I think that is so insane. There were parts of it that I thought were super cringy, but like I think things like that just come with cringe, like, and it's okay. It's completely okay. I had a really good time though. Oh, this is a really nice view. Let me see if I can take a picture of it once I'm done. Like, I really like this view. But there's a car coming and I don't know if I can take the picture. If I get off the road, I can. I already said this when I was walking there, but people have been so friendly, and I'm very shocked because I have RBF. Like, I never, like, in the past 4 hours alone, the amount of people that have approached me or like started conversation or just like initiated conversation with me is insane. Like, because I have RBF, like I normally scare people away. Like I don't have the most inviting or like the most welcoming, like, smiley face. Like, I don't really be smiling when I walk around like that. So it's pretty interesting. There's a lot of characters in the city too, which it just makes it fun. I'm excited for tomorrow. I need to rest though. I'm actually so tired and I'm still flustered, which is completely understandable. So I will rest at some point tomorrow. I'm excited. I'm at the Amazon Go Express store, and you don't have to, like, this store is crazy. Like, the technology, why are we suffering in Canada? Like, why do we not have this in Canada? Saying in the grocery store, so I went to the Amazon Go Express or whatever, and I've never been there because we don't have it in Canada, but I've seen it on like Aaliyah's face vlog, like from a while ago. But like, you would have to put your stuff in like the cart, and that's how they would know what you bought, right? No, first of all, I'd have to log into my Amazon app and then scan a QR code that gives me access to the grocery store. All right. And then I just pick stuff up and then I walk out and I'm done. That's crazy. Obviously you get charged to your Amazon account, but I'm just like, that's so weird. And like, I hate when things like that happen because I look like an uncultured babe being like, oh my god, this is so technologically savvy. Where are you coming from? Canada. Like why do we lack so much in Canada? Like, not lack, but do you know what I mean? Like, the difference between the States and Canada is quite large in terms of these kind of things. Like, and I get it. There's more people in America. But like, Why do they get all the cool stuff? My task for tonight actually is to build this. It's like a door stopper. So this place actually, which is really, really nice, it already has a door stopper like on the, like by the lock. I'm traveling alone and I'm a girl. Like, you have to take precautions, like, you have to for your safety. So I bought this door stopper that like, it wedges the handle so like nobody can like open it up. This door does have one, but it allows the door to open before it hits the stopper. This one should stop it from opening, period. Obviously I'm praying for God's protection over my life as I'm here. But I bought this as extra protection.
please listen to the following options. Press 1 for door code and studio access information. Press 2 to reach a member of our team. Your call has been forwarded to voicemail. The person you're trying to reach is not available.
Good morning. I found out that there's a solid core class, a solid core studio close by, and I've never done Pilates reformers, so I wanted to try it out, but I don't know if you can like just drop in because I don't have a membership, obviously. So that's what I was trying to call, but I might just have to like go there and see. I just want to pay for a class and take it. I really want a hot drink and a pastry right now. So I'm gonna get up and get ready. I have some stuff that I just wanna get done at a coffee shop. I'm gonna take a meeting from there as well. I'm actually also gonna use this time when I go out to solidify where I wanna go for dinner. There's so many spots to choose from. Oh God. But right now I really want a pastry and a hot drink. Ooh. A decaf latte with oat milk right now. Don't play with me. And a croissant. Croissant. I need more than a croissant though. Like I need like a breakfast sandwich. Yeah. Found a coffee shop that apparently has the best avocado toast in town. I'm not interested in avocado toast at all, but I did see a breakfast sandwich that looked really, really good, and it looks like they have spots to like sit and stay a while. So we're gonna do that. I'm looking for a brunch, not a brunch spot, breakfast spot, like I said. I walked by this chocolate store that looked like it might have been a vibe, like coffee shop vibe. There was tables, I could sit there for a little bit and get like a hot chocolate. So I might check out this place that I'm going to. If it's not the vibe, I think I'm gonna go back to the chocolate place.
You're crazy.
Oh my God.
Tennessee?
Closed.
Oh, are most things closed right now?
Everything's closed. I'm hungry.
It's Saturday. Everything not open till about 10 o'clock.
What's open? Oh,
I think it's almost 10.
Oh, yeah, it is 10. I don't know why everything's closed.
You trying to go eat with us?
I'm heading to a coffee shop right now. But
coffee?
Well, no, actually.
I
just like, I like decaf, but
oh,
yeah.
Man, you like the flavor? Oh, hell no.
What was your name?
My name's Swa.
Swa?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. And
thank
your name?
Greg.
What's your name?
Tammy.
Oh, hi, Tammy. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah. We finna go get drunk.
Okay. Well, you guys have a good day.
Yep, you too.
It was great to meet you guys.
To each other again.
No problem. Yeah. I was just walking, and then the guy looked at me, and he was like, what are those things under your eyes? So I told him, I was like, oh, eye patches, you know, to help with, like, puffiness and stuff. And then we just started talking. We've been walking together for the past like 5 minutes, like those two people, Swa and Greg were their names, and they were like, where are you from? Like, you don't look like you're from here, da da da. It was great. This is what I mean by like people are so vocal here. Like, he looked at me, he was like, what? And then he asked the question, whereas like in Canada, like people will look at you and like they're not gonna ask you any type of question at all. Like, you're not getting any kind of conversation from anybody. I just thought it was fun, and they were a chill vibe. Pretty cool. Thank you.
I spent a couple hours in that coffee shop, and then when it came time to pay, I didn't have my wallet. Like, I forgot my wallet in my hotel room, and not only was that embarrassing, but it was just like, oh my god, like I spent 3 or so hours in a place and now it looks like I can't pay for the meal. Oh god. But the guy was so nice. He was like, oh, like you can come and settle it later, just like promise that you'll come back, obviously. And I was like, 110%. I even bought my order again because I was like, now I just feel like a menace to society. Like, I feel like I haven't I don't know, like I don't know how I left the hotel room without my wallet, but I did. But I got another chicken sandwich to go for the afternoon because it was so good. Like, the red onions and everything they put in there, the spices, ooh, too good, too good. I ended up just like trying on glasses, which one of them is kind of cute, but I wish it was a bit more like I want glasses that like wrap. Do you know what I mean? Like, they don't, like, it's not just like the regular frame of a glass. Like, I kind of want it to like wrap like around your face, if that makes sense. So there's a pair that I was looking at that I do quite like, but I'm gonna give it a couple of days and see. And then if I don't find what I'm actually looking for, then maybe I will. I also don't have to get the sunglasses, but sunglasses is one of those things I think if you find, like if you see one that you like, I think it's better to just buy it then, because you will use it if you use sunglasses. Do you know what I mean? Anyway. I want the most rom-commiest of, oh yay, rom-com, here we go. So All the Boys I've Ever Loved, that was so good. Honestly, To All the Boys I've Ever Loved was like the rom-com that everybody needed. Like, they brought back rom-coms for real, for real. I actually am taking myself out to dinner today, which we're gonna get into later because I actually don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm taking myself out. I usually put gel in my eyebrows, but sometimes it makes them a little gray and then I have to like go over them, so I'm actually not gonna do that. I'm just gonna add a little pencil to them. Here's the conundrum, right? I don't know. My initial plan was to like go to like a nice restaurant and just like take myself out, you know? But then I was thinking, wait, why don't I like, maybe I should go to a bar, cause it's, and this, okay, hear me out. That sounded like crazy. It's a Saturday night and like, I don't know, I feel like it's like a good day, like going to a bar and sitting down and like a nice bar, right? And like ordering a drink and some food as opposed to like going to a restaurant. I don't know. But that would mean I'd have to be like talkative, and I'm not talkative the way some people are talkative. Like, I listen a lot and I feel like people think that like I'm not interested in talking to them, but I'm like, I'm really just listening to you right now. Like, I walked by a place up there that might be a good option, but I wanted to keep walking and see. I did see the Sheraton yesterday and like the Sheraton Hotel, like their restaurant. So I kind of want to just like walk by there and see if it's even something that I would be interested in. If not, I'll come back up here and go to the one that I saw. But yeah, I don't, I'm going to be very proud of myself if I actually go through with it and like sit at a bar, because I'm just so awkward like all the time. Like, I'm just, oh my god. Going out to eat by yourself is one thing, but I think like sitting at the bar and like potentially just engaging in conversation with like the bartender. Ah!
dangerous. But she's from Nicaragua, thought she was Persian.
Okay, so I successfully sat at the bar. I made a conversation with the bartender and then one of the servers. They were so funny. And just really nice people, honestly. It wasn't as busy. I missed the rush. The guy, his name was Leo. And I didn't get the other guy's name, but the bartender, his name was Leo. He was telling me that I think lunch is like super busy for them. And yeah, so it wasn't too crazy. This place was a lot more calm than like the other place that's like way up the hill was, which I was okay with. Yeah, I wanted a nice dinner and I definitely got that. I ordered dessert as well. I don't know who asked me to do that because I'm stuffed, absolutely stuffed. And I got a cocktail. I haven't had an alcoholic beverage in quite a long time, so it definitely hit, but it was actually so good. It tasted like, he was telling me they had like a vodka base, and I don't like vodka, so I was like, I wasn't gonna pick that option. But then he said that it tasted kind of like Sour Patch Kids, and I was like, sign me up. So I enjoyed my experience, and now I'm about to get cozy up in bed because I'm full, I'm satisfied, I'm tired. Actually, I'm not that tired, if I'm being completely honest, but it's cold. It's colder than it was last night, so I'm excited to go back to warmth. Happy Sunday. I am looking for Sephora, or not looking, I'm on my way to Sephora. I really want to try the Topicals Slick Salve lip balm. I'm pretty sure it's sold out, but it's worth a shot. What else do I want to get? I want to get the Topicals and then the Danessa Myricks Yummy Skin. And then I was looking at the Fenty Skin lip oil. So we'll see. It should be, oh, it's right there. I see it. Okay, so she got me the serum foundation and then also the skin tint. I'm gonna try. Really light. They look very light. It's still too light for my whole face. Yeah, no. Thank you so much. Bye. Okay, so I didn't get the Topicals lip balm, but I did get the Danessa Myricks skin tint. A lovely woman tried to help me find my shade by using the Sephora tool, and I'm not gonna lie, every time I use it, it goes lighter than I need. So when she gave me my tone, I very nicely, like, I played along with her, and then afterwards I tried myself, and lo and behold, I went a tone darker, which is fine. And then the Fenty Skin stuff, I just decided that I can get it back in Canada because the USD to CAD conversion is disgusting. So might as well just wait. But yeah.
Oh,
Good morning. Happy Monday. I stayed up so late yesterday, and then I realized that, so I'm on my way to the Museum of Pop Culture, and it is a 35 minute walk from my hotel. And I stayed up last night just like watching YouTube and stuff, and then I realized that I booked my ticket for 10 a.m. Now, I don't know why I did that, or maybe I got like time zones mixed up or something, but I'm trying to make it that. I think I have an hour between 10 and 11 is when I can go in, so I'm gonna get there around like 10:30-ish. It's raining today. Seattle is very hilly, so that's cool. I mentioned that I wanted to go to a Pilates reformer class, right? Yeah, I'm okay. I'm not gonna do that because the walking that I've done, like, my body's actually really sore. So, oh my god, I didn't bring an extra battery. This one was fun. What was my favorite? My favorite thing was the Leica exhibit, which is like the stop motion. What are they? I don't think they're an agency. They're like a production team. absolutely loved it. I actually might watch, which one was it? I've watched Coraline and I've watched Kubo and the Two Strings before, but I think I might watch, forget the name, Missing Link. I might watch that today. I just love stuff like that. And then my second favorite thing was the Jimi Hendrix part. I really liked that. I didn't know a lot about Jimi Hendrix. And yeah, it was cool. Now I'm gonna go to a coffee shop for a little bit. It is raining today. There are coffee shops around here, but this is just a different part of where I am, but this is a different area than where I'm staying, which is like still downtown. It's just a different type of downtown, but I'm gonna go back to closer to my hotel because I like it better. So the other day I realized that there's a couple like cinemas around, and I checked the show times for one of them, and Mean Girls is showing today, so I was like, oh, I'll go to the theater. I wanted to go in the evening because watching a movie in the evening is 10 times better than any, I don't know, it's just cool. I think it's a vibe when like you go in the evening, but the way I'm tired right now, it was a showing, it was either between 3:30 or 3:40 and 7:30. And I was gonna do the 7:30 one, but then I wouldn't be out of there until like 9:30. And I don't think I'd be able to make it. I genuinely don't think I will. I'm so tired. And it's completely my fault because I stayed up stupid late yesterday, just like watching TV and chilling. And then I booked the Leica exhibit for 10 a.m. And I'm not sure if I said this earlier, but it actually wasn't for 10 a.m. No, it wasn't. I was correct. It was for noon. but one of the emails said 10, but my ticket said noon, and I didn't realize that my ticket said noon until I was almost there. And so I got there, I like chilled for a bit in one of their coffee shops. But I'm glad that I went that early because I was able to take my time. I was there for like 4 hours and I went through like all of the exhibits apart from the horror movie one, because I am not a horror movie kind of girl, like at all. So I didn't even put myself, Anyway, yeah. So I went with a 331. I changed my outfit into something a lot more. My other one was comfortable, but it just was a tad bit thinner than I needed because it's raining and it's pretty cold. And I want to be 10 out of 10 comfortable when I'm watching a movie. So I'm excited. I was dreaming about the cinema popcorn yesterday when I went to bed. So they better have some. And yeah, I think it should be a vibe.
I'm the only one here. I love that for me.
I don't know how I feel about that movie, if I'm being very honest. I feel like I could have watched 3 episodes of Superstore or 2 episodes of Modern Family and probably enjoyed it more. That's all I have to say about that. I have leftover pizza from last night, so I'm just gonna go back to my room and eat that and honestly just fall asleep. Like, I'm so, so tired. So tired. And yeah, I'm gonna enjoy. I'm so aware of my surroundings. Every time I hear a little ch-ch-ch, I'm looking around. You think I have headphones on and I can't hear anything? You're crazy, because they are on transparency mode. And most times, I don't even have anything playing. Just to cover my ears, because it was cold today. But I am gonna enjoy the rest of the walk. I have like shin splints. Is that what they're called? Shin splints? Shin splints. Yeah. That's why I will not be doing the Pilates reformer, because my body is sore, as if I've done like 3 workouts. To be fair, I've technically done like hours of walking each day, because I've just been walking everywhere, and I don't mind it. I just wasn't expecting my body to be sore like this. But yeah. Maybe at like, it must have been at like 2 a.m. or something, because I woke up
I went to bed so early yesterday because I was so, like, my body was just so fatigued. And then because I went to bed so early, I woke up at midnight, but I was, like, forcing myself to sleep, right? And then I started feeling crappy, like, so gross. Gross, but, like, also, like, energetic. Do you know what I mean? But I was tired. And that's the caffeine. So some places don't do decaf roasts. You'd have to just, like, take it down from a double shot of espresso to a single shot. So I was doing that, and I didn't mind doing that, like, 2 days ago, right? Because I was tired, so I was like, I need, like, I'll take the shot. Like, it won't be, it'll help me, right? And it basically caught up to me, which is why I don't normally drink caffeine to begin with. But I was like, okay, I can't go to a coffee shop in the morning. I need, like, fruit. So I ate some bananas, literally at, like, 4 a.m. I, like, propped myself up, ate some bananas, drank a bunch of water, trying to, like, get myself to feel, like, at ease enough to sleep. Because I just wanted to sleep, bro, so I would have energy for the day. Anyway, I say all this to say that I went to this smoothie shop, right? It was like a 30-minute walk, and it's pretty cold outside because it rained, like, all of yesterday. It's pretty cold. Like, the damp cold is crazy. Anyway, so I got that, and then I ordered, like, a parfait. You know those, like, yogurt granola things? It is so cold outside, and then that was cold. But I was like, I'm gonna eat it because I need the nutrition. But now I'm, like, freezing. So I came back here. I did some work. I came back. I finished what I was doing at the shop. I came back. And I'm gonna change into, like, the comfiest things I can actually find. And then I'm gonna head out again. I wanna go to Target, I think. Maybe. We'll see. If I can touch Target, I want to touch Target. I'm gonna go back to Gemini Shop. Is it called Gemini Shop? Gemini Room. I think it's called Gemini Room. It's the coffee shop that I went to a couple of days ago. And I'm gonna get that chicken sandwich again because I've been thinking about it a bit too much for comfort. And I can't go back home thinking about this sandwich like this. Like, I need another one. So I think I'm gonna do that. I'm not gonna get if I get a hot beverage, it has to be a hot chocolate. Like, caffeine needs to stay so far away from me. And even though it's cold, I'm just gonna put on a jacket. I'm so glad I bought my, like, faux fur jacket, because it's been holding me down. So my plan was to go to a furniture store and then, like, a couple stores, like Target. And then there was this, like, small, like Seattle t-shirt stores that I saw on, like, Saturday. So I've been, like, walking around and I haven't been able to find them. I did go to a furniture store. I'm not gonna go to Target because I just can't be asked to, and it's really just not necessary. I'm at Cheesecake Factory. I've never been to Cheesecake Factory before in my life. And I was walking and I was hungry and I realized that, look, babe, I decided that I'm not gonna go back and get that chicken sandwich because let me try something else. Like, I tried that once, let me try something else. So I'm just gonna get something here. I'm gonna eat. And yeah, today's just a chill day. I'm genuinely trying to relax. When I'm done here, I'm gonna go back to my room, probably nap. I need my body to actually be rested. Spicy, crispy chicken sandwich. Look how God works. Look at that. Look at that. I got hot chocolate. Did I forget that I said hot chocolate? Jesus. I just burnt my tongue.
all the taste buds are gone. Oh my god, that was hot. Can you imagine? I haven't had fries my whole trip. So good.
Junior Watson, I've been your mother. Junior Watson, I've been your mother. Tell him this. Did he miss? Junior Watson, I've been your mother. I can't really see where did I miss. Junior Watson, I've been your mind. Junior Watson, I've been your mind. Tell him this.
It broke.
Did he miss?
I had a switch.
Junior Watson, I've been your mind.
Ex-trippers.
New killers. Shot. Tell him. This on Gaga. On my mama. Made a promise.
That's a wrap on the solo trip. My flight got pushed back. Pushed back, pushed forward. I don't know how you'll say it. I say pushed back. So it got delayed by 2 hours. I was able to take my time this morning. But I'm going to do one last coffee run this morning because I need something warm. And the airport is probably about to charge me 3 times the price of what a regular like macchiato should cost. But yeah, I'm gonna do that quickly and then take my ass to the airport. But I hope you enjoyed hanging out with me on my first solo trip. I definitely enjoyed my time here and I enjoy taking you guys along with me. I will see you next week and I hope and pray that you have a beautiful rest of your week, rest of your month, rest of your year. But we'll see each other next week, so.
Junior Watson, I've been your mind. Junior Watson, I've been your mind.